Hey, Mark, how are you?
Hello.
Yeah, I thought I'd dress up. Why not?
Oh, all of a sudden you're, yeah, you look great. I love it. It reminds me of like a kid's show that I watched when I was a kid or something.
Yeah, it's the Care Bears. So I'm Grumpy Bear. So yeah, we're good. So how are you doing, mate?
Doing great. I'm Mark Mitchell, and I'm Instagram living all the way from St. Petersburg, Florida. So,
oh, nice. How are things there? They've been like kind of unveiling a little more than here in LA.
They have started to the first phase of opening up, so it's a little dubious, a little scary for me. I'm not sure we're really ready, but they're going ahead with some of it, and you know, I'm just trying to stay safe and socially distant and all that good stuff.
Have you been staying pretty creative during this process?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, the last 6 months, I was working on a major piece because I got a grant last fall, and it was part of that to be part of the spring exhibit with the rest of the artists that got grants. So I had been already immersed in this massive triptych that I was creating, 9 feet wide. It's the largest piece that I've done so far. But of course, you know, the pandemic has got my wheels turning. You know, I do a lot of social commentary and thematic kind of things in my work. So I know that it's all going to filter in my next pieces. I did do a little something in illustration for a local creative loafing. It's a newspaper here in the Tampa Bay area. So that's actually, I guess, my first piece. It's more of an editorial illustration kind of thing, but it's based on the end of the pandemic and what that looks like here locally. But I'm really excited. Again, this is actually the second time I've been involved with bGGallery and Gestalt projects. I was in a show a couple of years ago. And so I'm excited to be on board. This is a really fun show and a great theme.
Thanks. And do you have your piece there?
I do, in fact. It's right here next to me.
I love that, the goat.
Yeah. That's
or
the
sheep. Is it a sheep or goat?
I was looking it's actually a sheep.
Okay.
And so, yeah, I've done a handful of pieces. There were four that I submitted for this show. This is one that's up now on Artsy called Marketing 2.0. And so a lot of people are thrown by the title at first because you kind of, you know, I love to get people to sort of wrap their heads around, you know, what the idea is. But, you know, for me, the pieces that I've done with animals are always metaphoric for human behavior. So that's why I really gravitated towards the show theme. This one, you know, if you think about the instinct that we have as humans to follow, to be led, it's oftentimes a little bit, you know, not all that well thought through. And sometimes our leaders aren't really leading us in the right direction and we follow like sheep. But this one was really thinking about that in the online world because that's where we're all living these days. You know, there's some traps out there and there's trolls and there's, you know, scam artists and all that kind of stuff. And there's, you know, apps and platforms like this one that are all free. But you know, you have to agree to those terms, you know, as soon as you download one of those apps. And, you know, I know I don't read all the fine print. I don't know who does. So it always makes me wonder, you know, what's the catch? So the idea here is it's based on that icon that you get when you first sign up for Facebook. It's got that generic
face. I see it.
Head. And then within it, you get the sheep face.
I love that.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. And then the background, actually, if you look closely, is all ones and zeros, like the digital.
Yeah,
world.
I was wondering what the background, if that was words or what that was.
Yeah, it's ones and zeros, the digital world. And once on a side note, one of the fun things that when I was looking for reference material to do this piece, and find like the perfect sheep face, I stumbled onto Dolly, the Dolly, the first clone sheep. Do you remember that?
Yep, I know about Dolly. I watched it.
It was ever done on an animal, so it made sense even more so to use her face as a springboard for this painting.
Nice. And how big is that for people that might be interested in the piece?
It's 36. I'm too close to the camera. Let me give you a little more sense of scale. It's pretty big.
Okay.
it's 3 foot square, 36 by 36.
Nice. I really love that work. And I mean, how much do you think, you know, animals have human behaviors? Have you ever seen an animal? And obviously your piece shows a lot, but.
Yeah, well, you know, like I said, I've explored it a bit. I've got a piece that happened to be on the wall behind me called Fish Out of Water.
And oh, great.
That expression, and, you know, refers to people who feel out of place in their world. You know, something's changed. I think a lot of us are feeling that way these days because things are so strange living through this pandemic like we've never experienced before.
Thank you so much for showing your work.
Yeah.
And I love it. If anyone wants to take it home, don't forget to private message us, or you can reach out, you know, on Artsy, and there's a couple other ways. But if you get in contact with us, this can be in your home, and I think it deserves a great home. I really love it. Maybe I'll touch base with some. I actually know a Facebook, the fourth employee over there, so that they might like that. So
that would
you never know.
That would be amazing.
All right. Thank you, Mark. Thank you so much for your time, and
thanks
love
so
and peace.
Okay.
All right. Bye.
See you later.